material of flour. So for that we'll make a mold, and for that we need the scale. So take a strip of paper and roll it around the scale. Apply some glue. So apply a little bit of glue. Pull it out. And that's gonna be our mold for the petal. So you keep that aside and we start filling the petal up. Now for that, this beehive quilling style looks better when it's more dense. So for that we're using two strips of paper instead of one, and you start quilling. So quill about 2-3 rounds and leave it. Then move down, leave about an inch of strip and start quilling again. Move lower and continue the same process till the strip ends. So this is how it's going to look. Make sure you use two strips of paper instead of one. It'll look much better with that. You can also use two different shades, two different colors, red and yellow, orange and ivory, whatever you like. Yellow and green also looks very pretty. And you finish it off. This is how it's going to look. And now we're going to put this in this. So for that you require a tweezer, and you start with putting in a couple of roundels and you start twirling them and tightening up the rolls. You'll have to hold it down, hold it in. And I guess this much is enough. This is all, otherwise it'll all get smushed together. You cut off the excess, give this a proper shape, and you apply glue over it so that it stays in place or it'll just come off. Keep it aside to dry. I've already made a few petals and I've kept them ready, four of these. Now we'll make the bud. For that you take a strip of paper and make a tight roll. Glue it. Put these all together. Apply some glue on the bud. Place it on top of this. Press it in properly. And you hold it in your palm and press it down to give it a nice 3D effect. So this is one flower, a small version. I've made a bigger flower. And you can make leaves. And that's all. And this you can use once again as a magnet. You can also make the same style in a butterfly, into a butterfly, and that will also look very pretty. And you use this as magnets on your refrigerators, decorate your cards with this, and they're going to look really pretty. That's it, as simple as that.